The distinguished delegate of Iraq to make a statement.
Madam President, Madam Secretary General, congratulations. I'm pleased to take this opportunity to address this assembly. We, the people of Iraq, are concerned at the continuing deterioration of the situations in the Middle East. The Middle East is one of the most significant regions of the world because of its geopolitical situation, oil resources, and holy sites. Its internal politics revolve around ethnic, ideological, and territorial disputes and competition for Arab leadership. The security situation is further threatened by complex military dynamics involving former armies, non-state actors, as well as external forces and foreign direct covert interference driven by powerful economic interests. Dividing Iraq along sectarian or ethnic lines, as the US is contemplating, would worsen the situation for the country and the region. Regional states need to play more thoughtful roles, and the international community needs to reject the norms of use of force to bring peace to the region. The fast-changing political dynamics of the Middle East requires a clear understanding of the present situation of the region and the internal and external factors affecting or influencing it. A strong factor related to the internal politics of the Middle East is the issue of who leads the Arab world. Most Arab leaders have been overambitious in their desire to be acknowledged as heads of the entire Arab world in particular and of the Muslim world in general. Israel is playing an important part in this new dimension of the Palestinian issue by supporting al-Fatah and reassuring its help to fight the radical force of Hamas. Madam President, we are convinced that the fight can only be won by collective action of the community of nations. We all should address terrorism under a rubric of the United Nations and develop measured long-term strategies to eliminate terrorism and prominent steps to be taken to tackle the problems in the Middle East. Shukran.